Arrgh, mateys! I am the Asian Pirate. Today, I am cooking easy chicken pot pie. So what do we need for this chicken pot pie? Well, let me show you. You need chicken cut up into bite-sized pieces. Yum. What you also need is some of this new Campbell's Soups for Easy Cooking. I'm using the creamy herb and garlic variety. And for the crust, I'm actually going to use puff pastry sheets. You also need a bag of mixed vegetables. And since the mixed vegetables doesn't have any potatoes in it, I'm just going to dice up a potato and throw it in there with the veggies. And that's what you need for the pot pie. So obviously the first thing I'm doing is I'm chopping up the chicken. And then as soon as I get that chopped up, we're going to throw it in the saute pan and brown it. Now keep in mind, I am kind of doubling up on the ingredients a little bit just because I'm expecting family over for dinner tonight. So, you know, it's going to be pretty much based on your judgment as to how, you know, what ingredients you want and how much for the servings that you're doing. So now we're going to throw the chicken into the pan. Now, before I throw the chicken in the pan, I am going to season it a little bit. So what I like to use for my chicken recipes is paprika, salt, and pepper. I like the coarse ground pepper. And then one of my favorite recipe ingredients to cook with is something that you can pick up from the melting pot. It's called garlic and wine seasoning. This stuff is the bomb, so you can pretty much throw it on anything and it tastes delicious. So I'm going to start seasoning the meat. There goes the paprika. And some pepper. And I like to use kosher salt. This gives it a really good flavoring. And then the garlic and wine seasoning. And you can use a pretty generous amount of that. Okay. Once you get that all sprinkled on, mix it together. Stir in the seasonings. And then we're going to start adding this to the pan. I apologize for the jerkiness of the videos, but since I'm doing this by myself without help, makes it a little difficult. Now, while the chicken is cooking, I've already got my vegetables in a crock pot, and I'm going to heat this on high. I'm just trying to do some pre-cooking, that way by the time it gets to be around dinner time, I'll just throw everything in the casserole dish and throw it in the oven and bake it. So I'm going to throw everything together in the crock pot, and once I get it up to temperature, I'll put it on low because I don't want to overcook everything. So stand by. Okay, so the chicken is cooking up pretty nicely. As you can see, it's starting to brown, starting to get cooked. And what I did was I took a large potato and I peeled it, and then I diced it into fairly decent-sized, bite-sized pieces. So now we're going to throw these ingredients into the crock pot. So in goes the potatoes. Whee! Okay, sorry about that. And then we're going to throw the chicken in. So as you'll see here, I've thrown the chicken and the potatoes in with the mixed vegetables. And now we're going to add the Campbell soup mixes, and since I'm doing such a big helping, I'm going to use two packages of it. Okay, so I've just added the soup mix to the mixture. And now we're going to stir it up a little. Get everything mixed up really good. And there's your basic filling for the pot pie. Now, if you want to get a little fancy, you could probably put in like a quarter cup or half a cup of white wine into it to give it a little extra flavor. Maybe even chop up a celery in there for flavor. But as it goes, that's the basic ingredients to go inside. And then I'm going to let that simmer in the crock pot for a while until it gets close to dinner time, and then we'll throw everything in a casserole dish and we'll top it off with the puff pastry sheets.